This is the Ryder and Lisa replay.
Brought to you by Southtown Hyundai. Check out the Southtown Hyundai Advantage at southtownhyundai.ca.
Thank you for checking out the show. So there's an update on the Diet Coke button that Trump had on his desk in the Oval Office.
Yep. So he had a button installed on his desk for when he would be working. And when he'd hit this little red button, someone would deliver a Diet Coke on a platter for him, like a silver platter. This isn't a joke.
Which people are like, oh, that's so Trump. But that's also like awesome.
Yeah. Like, have you seen the Emperor's New Groove? The things he would get, like grapes fed to him.
Right. Yeah.
His hair brushed while he was on the throne. Like, let the guy have a Diet Coke every once in a while.
It was up to like 12 a day he was having.
What?
Yeah, that's what they said. Yeah.
That's so bad for your joints.
The update is that President Biden has had it removed. It was noted by a journalist that was there yesterday.
That's crazy because that's one day in. He's like, get this out of here.
If you had a button that you could press that would bring you anything, what would it bring? 780-784-7107.
Thank you for listening, Crystal and Terrence. She says, Terrence said his girlfriend, that's cute, and Crystal would want hot coffee in her car.
Are they texting in together like it's a couple?
I think Terrence is Crystal's
kid.
Oh. Crystal, we need to know who Terrence is. Is it your boyfriend?
Well, Terrence said he wanted his girlfriend delivered, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he's just trying to get some brownie points is my guess. Smart move, though. I like it.
Andy says melted cheese, of course.
Oh, that's okay, such
like,
a good one.
But, like, what do you mean by melted cheese? Is it in a bowl?
Yeah, anywhere.
What do you already have chips on you? Like, what's going on there?
You could put melted cheese on anything, really.
Yeah, a shoe. Like, I'd eat a shoe.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I would go with a Pepsi or Coke Slurpee, but only because I get really bad migraines, and that helps me a lot when I'm dying in a dark room, laying down crying. And that is the one thing that truly helps me.
I'd say like a rye Diet Coke would be pretty good. A little motivational speech from a pretty woman.
What?
Well, I'm just thinking.
What are they motivating you to do?
Keep working, because I'm sitting at the desk and I get distracted really easily. So if I had a lady come in and be like,
oh, okay, see,
be who you can be. And like, it, oh, okay, girl.
I didn't realize that we were pretending we were in the Oval Office.
Oh.
I thought this could be like wherever you are, because I was picturing myself like laying down with an ice pack. Boom, Pepsi Slurpee.
Okay, if it's anywhere, I'm a bit of a puck hog when I play hockey. So I'd like to be able to skate with a button, and whenever I press it, they pass me the puck. So I don't have to tap my stick on the ice.
Is it because nobody ever actually passes to you?
Exactly. It's because I'm like way behind the play.
Okay, we have some clearance on Crystal's relationship with Terrence. Terrence is her almost 18-year-old son, and his girlfriend lives in Mississippi.
Oh.
There we go.
So he wasn't doing it for just brownie points. Okay, that is cute.
Unless she listens to the podcast, then that's like extra brownie points.
Back scratches is another one I'd really like added to the list.
Okay, but who's doing it? You got to go next level with this. You got a button. It's giving you exactly what you want. Who's giving you back tickles?
The pretty lady that also gives the motivational speech, maybe.
So Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah, that. I mean, you want the big, dirty, fake nails. Not dirty. Like, I'm just talking like intense fake nails.
Right.
For the back scratches.
That are like super glued on.
Yeah, yeah. So anybody that has those, I'm fine with. All right, we're recommending things we've come across lately that could be just little morsels of information you may find interesting, or things we've actually discovered.
Yeah, so I didn't know this. PSA, if you use a nonstick or Teflon pan and the coating on it degrades, you have to get rid of it. It's a bit loud.
Sorry, this is my PSA song.
Oh, okay.
Public service announcement.
Yeah, you're supposed to get a new pan when that happens, because once the Teflon goes, you can actually find little microparticles of it in your food, which is obviously terrible for you. Most people listening right now are like, I'm going to pretend I didn't hear this. Nobody can afford to just buy new pans every time it starts to peel off.
Right.
Why are you laughing?
This music just sounds so inspiring with your important message.
Nobody needs those carcinogens in your body. So if your Teflon is breaking, throw it out the window.
All right. Nice work. I'm going to keep this music on for mine.
It's pretty funny. I actually have a friend that has always said that. He's like, don't buy expensive pans. Once I start to go bad, get rid of them, buy a new one, a cheap one.
Huh.
Who cares?
All right. My recommend something today is a new hummus that I tracked down.
Oh my God.
Safeway yesterday.
It's a game changer.
couple days ago, I guess I was at Safeway when I got caught behind the extreme couponer and was there for 3 hours.
Right.
I got COVID. So, no, the hummus I found was Everything Bagel Hummus by a company called Summer Fresh. And, like, do I have to even explain more? It's everything
absolutely
bagel.
Absolutely not.
The flavoring's incredible.
There's this hummus. There's this new trend where people are putting cream cheese and everything bagel seasoning on their peppers.
Mm.
This is, like, a way healthier alternative, and it's already pre-mixed for you.
So good.
So good. Safeway has it.
Give her a go. We've never done click and collect, eh, either of us?
No.
But it's getting more and more popular. I'm seeing more parking spots for people that are there for click and collect. So obviously more and more people are doing it. Your friend, you saw one of her posts that was pretty funny of a fail. So we wanted to talk about times that this goes wrong. Let's give her a ring.
Hello.
Okay, so your Instagram story made me laugh so hard. By the way, have you met Ryder? This is Chelsea.
Hi, Chelsea.
Hi, Ryder. I think I've met you once.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, that wild night on the dance floor at Cook County. Just you and me and a bunch of strangers.
Yeah, I don't know. I might have forgotten that time.
That might have been a different Chelsea.
Oops. Okay, so tell us what happened.
So I did the online grocery shopping thing.
Yeah.
And went there with my kids yesterday. I'm not even paying attention. And I kind of like look up as he's loading my trunk. And I'm like, wow, he's loading 800 bananas into my trunk. I'm literally like, oh no. So I just realized that I mixed up single bananas with bushels of bananas. So I now have 8 bushels still sitting on my entryway.
Okay, so like, what is the game plan now? Like, you have to keep these bananas, or are you going to try and like hand them off to friends? Are you going to make 17 banana bread loaves?
Are you going to buy a chimpanzee?
That's an option. Right now, they're just sitting on the entryway floor, and the kids can just pick them up as they go. And then otherwise, they can be added to the freezer with the black bushel that I have there already.
Right. Yeah, you're going to be making a lot of banana muffins.
I think so. Thank you so much for answering the call.
Enjoy the potassium.
Oh, thank you so much.
She's awesome.
Yeah.
All right. You've had an experience that didn't go real well either. Fire away.
I've ordered from Walmart, and sometimes you get a substitution. Other times they say, oh, well, we don't have it. So one time I went in and looked around, and the product was sitting on the shelf, and they said they couldn't find it. For the most part, they're pretty good, but there's the odd time where you're going, okay, did you even look for it?
Yeah, it sounds like it really depends on which employee's in charge of how it's going to go. Like, I know I've changed my grocery shopping habits. Like, okay. I used to just go there and, like, grab whatever. Who cares? When I was, like, 20, right?
I didn't realize that they kind of try and trick you. They put the most expensive stuff at eye level because it's the easiest to just grab.
Right.
So you got to get down.
Well,
you got to be able to squat. See, that's how they get you. They're like, most of these people that are coming through here have bad knees. They're not going to be squatting down to get the discounted noodles.
Right.
But yeah.
But yeah, like now I go and I'm meticulous with like finding which pepper I like the best,
right,
or which steak has, you know, the most fat in the right spots. Where when you online order, the guy,
they don't care about you.
They don't care
about you.
They're probably grabbing whatever one is out of date first.
They're probably grabbing the ones that fell on the ground. They're like, they won't know. They weren't here.
Let's give her some more bananas. So you're talking about the click and collect fails and like online fails in general. Sometimes you order something and it's not what you expected.
Johnny Jasno, that does the show after us at 10 a.m., said that his friend tried to order like a little thing of poppy seeds and ended up getting like a massive bag. So posted on Facebook and just like asked for poppy seed recipes. Like,
right,
what else are you going to do?
Well, I think, can't you grind poppy seed down and make drugs? I feel like that's something I heard once.
Well, now I need to look into
probably
that.
A lie.
Poppy seed drugs. Should I be typing this in on my work computer?
Any word?
Oh, wow. When harvested, the seeds can absorb and become coated by opium extract.
See? Well,
whoa.
So these are already harvested. It's probably too late. You don't want to get into that game anyway.
Can we move on?
You saw what happened to Breaking Bad. All right. You have an online order fail?
Yes. And I'm not going to elaborate, but I ordered leather gloves off of Wish. And that is it.
That's all you're telling us?
That's all I'm telling you.
Let me guess, they weren't meant for, like, driving or working?
They were not working gloves, no. Not my kind of work, anyway.
But you've used them since, right?
Okay, what happens in the bedroom? Just kidding. No, I threw them out. They were way too tiny for me.
Hilarious.
Yeah, and the sheen on them just made it look like black lipstick.
Perfect glove for the small pervert in your life.
That's right.
Thanks for the call, man. Appreciate it. So, Bridgerton is officially coming back for a second season. You said the show was great, very steamy.
The only reason I committed, because when I started it, I was like, oh, I don't know if I can get into this. But all my girlfriends had already crushed it, and they're like, wait for episode 5. It's steamy.
Okay.
I was like, oh, this is taking forever to get there. And then when you get there, you're like, whoa.
Worth
is this even
wait.
Allowed on Netflix?
Interesting. You said the music was amazing, too. They take a lot of new songs. Or newer songs, and then just make them sound and fit the feel of the show.
The genre. So a lot of just covers of songs, like Billie Eilish is on there, and Ed Sheeran, I think, is also a song, and they just play the violin version instead. This one is beautiful. It's Taylor Swift's Wildest Dreams.
I mean, is it?
It's so good.
Okay, here's a bit of it. You see that as beautiful. I see it as a challenge.
Ryder, Ryder, Ryder's recorder. Ryder, Ryder has no actual skills.
Before you get into this, I just have to read Rich's text. Did you know that you can watch shows at 1.5 speed on Netflix for faster viewing? Yeah, get to those steamy scenes faster. Let's go. Hilarious. Okay, challenge. For Ryder, try and make it as beautiful as the violin cover.
No, I'm not going as beautiful. I'm going more beautiful. Let's do this.
Not be surprised if they contact you
for season 2.
Yeah,
probably. Play 107. It's Ryder and Lisa. You discovered a fairly useful website for animal lovers.
Well, actually, I didn't discover it. Our listener, Shauna, let me know about it after I tweeted out saying, I can't believe people continue to watch Yellowstone
right
after that horse died. And that's the first scene.
Yeah, it's not a like. It's not like a horse accidentally dying either. Like, it's a pretty gruesome scene.
And it doesn't get any better. Like, I tried to, like, peek at some scenes every once in a while.
Yeah, I just watched yesterday and there was a bear that got taken out.
It's too stressful. And, like, the scenes are so loud. Like, does it have to be that loud? Anyway, so Shauna let me know about a website called doesthedogdie.com, and you can search shows before you invest time to watch it, and it can be any animal, and it'll tell you about any animal that dies in it before you waste your time.
Really?
And then you're distraught for the rest of the night.
Well, I know my daughter won't watch dog movies because she said the sadness that she feels in the low parts of the movie is more significant than how warm she feels when things get better for the dogs. So she says she just will not watch dog movies.
Well, even Beethoven is very hard to watch.
Right.
Yeah, and no dog dies in that. But anyway, I just wanted to let everyone know about this website. Thank you, Shauna. DoesTheDogDie.com.
Very different than DoingItDoggyStyle.com.
Ryder.
Don't go to that. Well, I just want to make sure people don't get in trouble at work. Because if you search, that's the second one. That's like a close...
Thanks.
You're welcome. There is some serious drama happening right now.
With young, new musical artists, there's a musical feud between two singers / actors that you need to be aware of because these songs are topping the charts so fast.
Mm-hmm.
It's just wild to me.
And they're good.
Yes.
Like there are now three songs out that mm-hmm. are all attached to this drama that we need to break down for you. So Joshua Bassett and Olivia Rodrigo are co-stars on the High School Musical series.
And they had amazing chemistry to the point where all of their fans were like, they're dating. Like, there's no way they're not dating.
So they apparently were dating. Then apparently they broke up. And that's when Olivia Rodrigo released Driver's License, which broke a ton of records.
Yep.
Like, most streams in a week, most streams in a single day, quickest song to get 100 million streams, and it went number one, debuting on the Billboard Hot 100. All massive accomplishments.
If you want to hear the comparison, Olivia Rodrigo's song Driver's License is at number one for streaming with like 66 million a day,
mm-hmm.
and in second place is Ariana Grande with only 25 million. So that is just crazy. Also, she's 17.
And you've heard her song here.
You've definitely heard it. It's so beautiful.
It's so sweet and beautiful that you have to be on her side. But you got to hear the rest of this out. So Joshua releases a song after the success of
Driver's License
called Lie, Lie, Lie.
So they told me all the things that you said, running all over my name. Oh, and you're acting not so innocent. Like I'm the only one to blame. You've been lying to yourself, lie to everyone else, only thinking about yourself. Darling, what the hell? I know what you said about me. I hope that it makes you happy.
Anyway, it goes
on.
Now, let's insert the third person into all of this drama.
Now, some of the lyrics in Driver's License are about a new blonde girl.
Yeah, I've got them right here.
Oh, yeah.
And you're probably with that blonde girl who always made me doubt. She's so much older than me. She's everything I'm insecure about. Yet today I drove through the suburbs.
So once again, that's the Driver's License.
Oh, it's so good. And Sabrina is older and blonde and has been seen out and about with Joshua. They TikTok together all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And she just released a song at midnight, and it's already in the top 20.
Sabrina,
at midnight.
Sabrina Carpenter is most well-known for A Girl Meets World.
And she's going to be Alice in the new Netflix Alice in Wonderland.
So yes, like Lisa said, she's released a song now called Skin.
Now, this is a lot of information, but maybe a lot of you need to be aware of this when your kids are talking about the latest hot gossip.
Right?
You're welcome, okay? Here it is.
So, Olivia, Joshua, rumored to date, break up because of a blonde girl, potentially.
Here she is.
Maybe we could have been friends if I met you in another life. Maybe then we could pretend there's no gravity in the words we write. Maybe you didn't mean it. Maybe blonde was the only rhyme. The only rhyme. Want my heart to be breaking, breaking.
Yeah,
just say, well, he's on my skin?
Yeah, he's on mine. Dude. All of my skin.
Why am I so invested in this, like, near 20-year-old drama? It just reminds me so much of the Hilary Duff versus Lindsay Lohan when Aaron Carter was on the set of the Lizzie McGuire show.
Right.
And then him and Lindsay. Oh, my gosh.
So the thing that I've noticed is Olivia's lyrics, she seems to be almost complimenting Sabrina, if that's the blonde girl.
She's like, everything she's insecure about.
Yeah. And then Sabrina comes back with, like, fire. So they must be very upset with how well this song is doing and how much backlash they're having to deal
it's
with.
It's just such a brilliant way to get yourself into the top 10 on the charts. Like, I'm invested and I'm a 31-year-old woman.
This is why monogamous relationships, not necessary all the time. Like, why can't they just be a perfect trio, a triangle of love?
It happens all the time, you know.
That would make some good music as well. So you pointed out that you really like the smell of Canadian Tire.
Yeah.
And we've talked about it a couple times. And it keeps coming up from, like, women who didn't realize that they loved the smell of Canadian Tire so much. But now that you've said that, when they go, they'll text us and be like, I'm just like Lisa, apparently. Uh-huh. Smell of Canadian Tire.
It's a good scent. It reminds me, like, of my childhood. It's like, I love the smell of the tires and the wood. I don't know. I love it.
The wood? Is there a lot of wood
there?
Oh, sorry.
I'm complaining it with, like, Home Depot. Like, that's the smell you get when you go into there. And then Canadian Tire, you get the tire smell.
We're talking about just other places you walk into and the smell immediately hits you.
Yep. This is kind of a weird one, but Lara wrote in saying, I love the smell of basements.
Hmm.
She said, when I was pregnant, I literally wanted to lick the walls. I'm like, that's like that's like a smell of mildew, though.
So she was probably like lacking vitamin C or something that mildew is high in. Because I know that a lot of pregnant women will like crave the smell of asphalt, and it has to do with a lack of iron because there's so much iron in asphalt. So maybe she was just lacking something. I know for me, when I walk into Red Lobster, I'm lacking hot butter.
Hot butter air.
And the garlic in there and the smell of the seafood. I just know I'm not going to be proud of myself with how much I eat.
Yeah.
But it's going to be the best time ever.
Well, we're going to be like supporting. We got to get back into those restaurants, man. Kate said the smell of a tattoo shop.
Mm.
Is that like burning skin?
No,
like, what is that?
It's actually, I think, mainly like how clean they need to be kept.
Oh, okay.
So it smells kind of like a surgery room.
Not only that, but the sound of the needles running just releases endorphins.
What is your favorite establishment to walk into just because of the smell? Growing up, when you'd walk into a hotel lobby that had a swimming pool and you knew it was about to go down.
And you're like, I know there's a slide.
So that like chlorine in the hotel entrance smell, that's one of my favorites.
What about a nice brewery?
Mm.
The smell of a brewery?
Yeah, but I love beer. Breweries to me smell like burnt wheat.
Oh.
A little bit. Like, I don't know if the breweries do it for me scent-wise.
This is hilarious to me. Also kind of odd, but that's okay. No judgment. Trey says, my daughter loves the smell at the bottle depot.
No. What?
I don't know.
That's a weird...
It's
one of my least favorite. Also one of my least favorite places to wear flip-flops.
Quite sticky. Quite sticky.
780-784-7107. Establishment, what do you got?
I love the smell of the entrance closest to the big food court in West End.
See, that's a good answer.
Yeah, that's a whole bunch of different smells coming at you. You got
those, like, just punch you right in the face.
Your fried chicken, you've got your French fries, the Chinese food places. The
cinnamons.
Probably cinnamon a homeless guy's pee somewhere around there.
Yeah.
You get the whole shebang.
It really is that little hint of pee that gets you.
Absolutely.
It's like all that food,
a little bit of
and
B.O.
Then that.
Play 107.
Even if you don't get it, you've seen the Bernie Sanders meme.
Because he was wearing like a normal jacket and some woven mittens and looking like he didn't care at all at the inauguration. And people have been putting the iconic now already picture of him in different places.
Well, he's already made it into the Bobblehead Hall of Fame.
Right. Insane.
Like within 24 hours of that meme.
The UFC one might be my favorite so far. Like, what's just that? The way he's sitting, it looks like he's got a guy in an arm
bar. Oh, that's great.
And then, like, Joe Rogan's in the background all excited. That one made me laugh pretty hard today.
Okay, there was one with the Game of Thrones.
Yeah,
it
was good.
The last episode of Game of Thrones was really good.
Just when I think I'm over it, somebody takes it to the next level or hits me with one that I'm like, oh, that's still funny.
That's so good.
I'm not even going to try to think about being over it. I'm just going to enjoy that the internet is now a place again where there's peaceful laughter and nonsense rather than just hatred and division, which has really consumed social media for the last year.
Okay, but we did post some on Play 107's Instagram and there were some haters. They were like, we're over it.
Yeah.
I was like, speak for yourself.
People are trying to get angry. I even noticed the comment section under the video of Bernie being interviewed by Seth Meyers, and people are trying to make it political, but it's just not taking off. People are having too much fun with it. Here's what Bernie had to say about the whole situation.
Really nice, Seth, is the woman who made the mittens lives in Essex Junction, Vermont. She is a school teacher and is a very, very nice person, and she has been somewhat overwhelmed by the kind of attention that is being shown to her mittens.
That's the cutest.
It's just a sentence I never thought I'd hear somebody say this.
By the kind of attention that is being shown to her mittens.
What?
Ryder and Lisa.
Brought to you by Southtown Hyundai.
Play 107.